If you use commercial fonts, chances are you bought at least some of your fonts at myfonts.com, which is currently the biggest online shop for fonts. But what do you put in this field during checkout? Well, let's find out what you should and shouldn't do in regards to this field. Since I'm selling fonts on MyFonts myself, I know that font customers like graphic designers will often put the name of the clients they work for in here. And it's easy to see why. It says who is this font for, and a client is one of the given options. So should you put your client's company name in here if you design something for a client? Actually, no, that's usually not what you want to do, especially when buying desktop licenses. It would mean that you buy a license for your client, but not for yourself or your studio. And as a result, legally, you wouldn't even be allowed to use the fonts. If you download and install them anyway, this would actually be an illegal font use. The licensee of a desktop font needs to be whoever wants to install the fonts to render text with them. And with professional design work, that's usually the design studio. So you need to purchase the license in your name or the name of your studio. But then, what is the purpose of this field? It allows you to be the one making the payment without becoming the licensee. For example, if you work at a design studio and buy a font license, then the studio should become the licensee, not an individual employee of that studio. So you put the studio's name in there. But there can also be cases where you actually want to put the client's name in here. Let's say you bought a license for your design studio to create a corporate design for a client. And later the client also wants to install the fonts you picked as corporate fonts on their own computers. You could just tell the client to purchase the appropriate font license at MyFonts, but they probably have never bought a font license before and might not know how that works. So in this case, you can also buy the license for them. So after you already purchased the license for your studio, you make a second purchase in their name, and then they would also become a licensee who is able to install and use the fonts. That's it for this episode. If you want to learn more about font licensing, I'm currently putting together an online course about this topic. And until it is available to the public, my supporters on Patreon get early access to all lessons while they are being created, without being required to pay for the course itself. So feel free to head over to Patreon to check out this offer.